Welcome back to Will and Mabel, and you are not only joined by Mabel the super puppy today, but as you just saw, Sully my super Labrador is knocking around as well. But here's Mabel, 9.5 weeks old. If you're new here, I did a video yesterday on the ways that a puppy will drive you absolutely insane. Even for a professional like me that's done it plenty of times and helped thousands of people to raise amazing canine companions, it really is difficult, and I wanted to share that experience with people to know that you're not alone when you're going through difficult times. So if you haven't seen that video, I recommend you going and checking it out. But once you've checked out that video, I've decided to do one today about the best things about owning a puppy, because let's face it, they're man's best friend for a reason. Now we'll jump straight into it, and we'll start with the obvious one, and you can tell for yourself, but they are just incredibly cute. Mabel, what's this? Say hello. What's this? Oh, you are so cute. Yes you are. Now like I mentioned yesterday, puppy cuteness can wear off quite quickly when they start doing some of the more infuriating things that come with owning a puppy. But even so, at the end of a hard day, to be able to come home and to look at a puppy wagging its tail, happy to see you and wanting some cuddles, there isn't much better in the world than that. And no matter how infuriating and difficult they can be, they only stay this small for a very, very short amount of time. They grow so quickly. Mabel's 9.5 weeks. We've had her for 1.5 weeks and she's already growing. Like, she can have a nap in the day, wake up after a couple of hours, and you can literally see that she's grown. So they don't stay like cute puppies forever. So enjoy it while they do. Take loads of pictures, take loads of videos, and have it to treasure and look back on, because puppies are insanely cute. Which ties us into the next thing, which is what I'm doing right now on the floor with Mabel, even though she's getting a bit fed up with me lifting her up all the time, but puppy cuddles. So not only do the puppy cuteness stage quickly go, but these puppy cuddles, where they're small enough to be able to sit on your lap and they've got that special puppy fur and that puppy smell and that puppy ability just to fall asleep and nap anywhere, even in the most uncomfortable of positions like this, this also doesn't last very long. So there is no cuddle in the world like a puppy cuddle, except maybe my toddler cuddle. They're pretty awesome as well. But let's face it, puppy cuddles are amazing and they don't last forever. So like I say, Sully's next to me at the minute. He's not interested in cuddling like this. He's happy just to be lying next to me and near me, and I'll give him the odd scratch behind the ear. But this form of being on top of you and wanting to be able to be cuddled like this and fall asleep like this doesn't last very long. So again, lap that up. That is one of the best things about having a puppy. Right, so we'll move on from some of the obvious stuff. And for me, because if you're new here, I'm a canine behaviorist. I work with dogs every day. It's what I do for a living. I've helped thousands of people raise perfect canine companions. It's an absolute joy. But even no matter how many times you do it, there's something amazing about being able to watch just how quickly a puppy can learn, especially when you instigate a plan right from day one, like my Perfect Puppy course. You can check out, there's a link in the description below if you're interested in how I train puppies and how I'm training Mabel. But if you instigate a plan and you're consistent with it, watching just how quickly their little minds can pick things up from obedience through to just how to be well-mannered and how to be well-socialized animals is an absolute joy to behold. It's a fascinating thing just to be able to experience and watch and be a part of. And by the way, if you want more super cute pictures of Mabel here, make sure you go and check us out on Instagram. Will and Mabel IG, all one word. Again, links are always in the description box below for you to check out. My next favourite thing about having a puppy is kind of similar to not only watching how they learn, but watching them develop relationships. Right, from day one, I'm a big advocate of getting your dog out there and socialising them, even if they haven't quite finished their jabs yet, which Mabel hasn't. You have to take precautions and be careful and make sure they're safe and not picking up anything that they shouldn't be. But it's so important for them to socialize with other people, other environments, other dogs, other animals. Again, I break down exactly how to do that in my course, but it's so important. But what's beautiful about that is watching them develop those relationships, especially, obviously it's good to meet strangers that you won't meet again, but meeting the people and the families and the other animals in your life and watching those relationships grow is amazing. Mabel already, 1.5 weeks in, acts differently with me than she does with my wife. And she acts differently. We've got a nearly 4-year-old son and a nearly 1-year-old son. And she acts differently with both of those. And she's starting to develop different relationships with different members of the family. She's got a lovely relationship with my mum and dad when we come here, and one of my favourite things to do is watching her relationships with different animals. We've been spending a lot of time here where there's my Labrador is staying here with my mum's very old Jack Russell because he just loves being here and with her. Like I mentioned in an old video, we're kind of aware that she's going into the last probably month or so of her life. She's 18 years old now. Sully's kind of become a carer, so he spends a lot of time here. And when she passes away, she'll be coming back and spending living back with us and Mabel. Anyway, watching the way that she has a relationship with Sully, who's super playful, very energetic. He's still only 3 years old, so he loves to play with her, yet he's teaching her how to play. He's teaching her manners. He's teaching her how to be appropriate with dogs, when's too much, when's not enough. Fascinating. And it's a completely different way to how she reacts with the husky. The husky's not that old. She's an adult. I think she's about 7 years old. So she's getting on into her senior years, but she's still full of energy. But she's very independent and recluse. She likes her own space. So she tells Mabel off when she goes too close to her or goes too near to her bed or to her crate. And Mabel's learning some manners and some respect and how to react, that you can't just react like you can with Sully. And then with an older dog like the Jack Russell, she is absolutely superb. Very gentle, very calm. Kind of tries to initiate play, but then realizes she can't, and it's beautiful to watch. Relationships between dogs and humans and dogs and dogs is absolutely fascinating, and when you get your own puppy, if you ever do, being able to see that grow and shape and mold is fascinating. And then my last favorite thing has to be about a puppy, is just shaping their character and their temperament. Every breed has a different temperament and characteristics, and within every breed there's a variety of different temperaments, even within different litters. Like I discussed how it is that I chose Mabel out of the litter when there was dogs within the same litter that had completely different characteristics. But your impact on that as they grow forward and move forward is absolutely fascinating. And that's why I always say that from day one, you need to start on a plan. You need to start making sure that they're well socialized. You need to teach them good manners. You need to make sure that there's a good obedience routine in place so that they come into the world with routine and understanding what it is that you expect from them. But seeing how that routine and that schedule and that plan that you implement shapes them is absolutely fascinating and is the best part of raising dogs. Just like people, all dogs are different, but your ability to shape their behavior and shape their characteristics, utilizing a good plan to make them fit in with your lifestyle and make them be perfect canine companions, is the best part of a puppy. And when you get a puppy at just 8 weeks old, you've got the maximum chance of really being able to shape it to fit your personality and your lifestyle perfectly. I'm a huge advocate for adopting dogs, and when you adopt an adult dog, you can still do that. Dogs are very flexible and moldable and malleable to new situations and environments, but adult dogs do often come with difficulties and behavioural issues, especially those that have been given up for adoption often do come with challenges, and is one of the things that I most spend my time helping people fix those issues. But when you start with a puppy, you've got the ability to get it right the first time round, which is what I preach. It's all about putting the work in now so that you can reap the benefits later. It's hard work now, I discussed that in yesterday's video. It's tiring, it's frustrating, and it can be infuriating. But if you put the work in, get it right the first time round, then you get that perfect canine companion that you've always dreamed of. Now, if you are looking for help on how to do that, I have got my Perfect Puppy course that is listed down in the description box below, so you can go and check that out. If not, carry on watching these videos, and I'm going to be explaining how it is that I'm training her, showing you how I do it, taking you along for the journey of all the fun times that we're going to have with her as she develops into our family guardian. So thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you click like, subscribe if you're new here, and I'll see you on the next episode of Will and Mabel.